So when I moved into this new home, one of my main priorities was to dedicate a room for my sacred space, a place where I could come home to my soul every single day, where I could meditate, mantra, pray, read my spiritual books, and allow me to be fully present in the now. You know, I've talked about becoming more and more present with this moment, because this is where all of my power is. And having this sacred space really helps me to become more and more present with the now, because I can focus, I could have the stillness, the quiet. You know, they always say silence is the language of God. And so when I come into this space, I can really connect with the divine energies within me and around me of God and this universe. So it was really important for me to create this sacred space. So I want to share with you what I've done with my own sacred space to give you some ideas to create your own sacred space. So I'm standing at the entryway of my sacred space, and I want to place a namaste sign here to welcome myself whenever I come into the space, or welcome my guests when they come into the sacred space. And namaste essentially means the divine being in me honors the divine being in you. It's saying that we are one, we are not separate, we are not dual, because everything in this universe is connected, it's intertwined. It all comes from that one source energy. So the Buddha said, I am one with the universe, and the universe is one with me. So when I say namaste to you, I'm saying we are connected. We are the same. We are connected by this spiritual energy. And that's why it was important for me to place this namaste sign. And both these artwork were created by individual artists. You know, I really want to support individual artists. So both of these artworks were created by individual artists, and I could really feel their spiritual energy coming through in their art. So I think these pieces are both really beautiful. So the most important element in any sacred space is the altar, or what they call the puja. And I had my altar table actually custom designed by an artist, and had the artist carve in an Om symbol and the yin and yang logo on both sides, you know, the crescent moon and the round sun. And so the main focus on any altar table is the divine being. I have the Buddha along with some Lakshmi and Shiva statues over there. It's because we're making an offering, we're honoring, we're acknowledging the divine presence. And so we're going to have a divine being at the center. And we also want some fire elements. So here I have some incense that I light up when I do mantras or prayers or meditations, or I light up the incense to connect with my spirit guides, especially my late sister Sun. I like to speak with her on a consistent basis. So you want to have the divine, the fire element, and I also place some crystals around the puja table to raise their energetic vibrational frequency of this room. And so you don't have to have a separate altar table to create a sacred space. Like this one is custom designed, you don't have to have that. If you live in like a little studio, then maybe you have a side table, you know, next to your bed. Make that your altar table. Place, you know, some candles, a divine being, you know, and some crystals on that table. Or maybe you have a cabinet in your house, or, you know, some kind of a little console table, and you can make that your altar table. You don't have to have something like this. It doesn't have to be custom made. It all depends on where you live, how much space you have. You could live in a studio and have an altar in your studio. So what's most important is to just have a space in where you live that's dedicated for offering, for honoring, for acknowledging the divine being. That's what it's about. It's not about taking one room, having a dedicated room for sacred space. That's not what it's about. I've been fortunate that I have a room to do that. But if you don't have that space, you don't have the extra room, or you live in a studio, you don't need to have a dedicated room. You can just take a space in wherever you live, in the studio, one bedroom, whatever it is, and just create a little altar. And that's enough. That's enough. So just remember, as I show you my sacred space, I'm just giving you some ideas of what you can do, but it does not have to be a dedicated room to have a great sacred space in your home. So this entire black and white pictured wall was inspired by this painting by my late sister's son. You know, when son was going through cancer, we went to Germany to get alternative cancer treatments, and she took a calligraphy class. And she painted this in within like 10, 15 minutes. It was so fast. And look how beautiful it is. All these like kind of like stems that just kind of go up, and then there's butterflies and caterpillar. And then she even signed it in Korean, her name, Cho San Hang. So this entire wall was inspired by this beautiful black and white picture by my late sister's son. And I decided to use other black and white pictures that had a lot of meaning, like the Shiva image up there, the heart shapes, the Om symbol, the peace symbol, the yin and yang symbol, the crescent moon and the round sun, the lotus flower, you know, different yoga positions. So I decided to really just expand this wall into an entire black and white pictures with images that had spiritual meanings. So I really, really love this wall because it was really inspired by my late sister's son's beautiful calligraphy painting. So I needed to house all of my spiritual books. So I decided to make this side of the room where I could place a bookshelf to house all of those books. And then I placed these beautiful pictures by individual artists. Actually, this picture of the hummingbird and the elephant were created by a Reiki master lady. And these two canvas paintings, the lotus flower and the silhouette of the Buddha, were created by an artist in Washington. And so when I moved into this new home, I made a conscious decision to support individual artists because they really need to be supported. Because without art, we have no soul. Without creativity, our soul is empty. And the way we fulfill our soul, part of fulfilling, expanding, and really growing our soul is to have creativity in our life. And therefore, art is so important. And so every picture you see in my house was created by an individual artist because I really want to support their mission, their goal, their creativity. And so the other side of the wall is a Buddha statue I brought from my old house, and above it is the Om symbol, and that was also created by an artist in India. And I like this wall in contrast to the black and white wall because this wall has more color, and the opposite of this wall is the black and white pictured wall. So I really like having that contrast. So I feel really honored to share my sacred space with you, and hopefully for those of you who don't have a sacred space already, that my sacred space has inspired you to create one. And so please share your sacred space with us. You know, your feedback, your tips, your comments really help me and my community at large. And if you like this video, please make sure to share it and subscribe to my channel. And if you want to visit all of my spiritual and holistic living tips, just go to my website at yinandyangliving.com. Thank you. Namaste.